As unique as our Leela Punawala Foundation family, I wish to invite the dignitaries on the dais, our chief guest, Mr. Minocher Patel, guest of honor, Mr. Nikhil Kaushal, Leela Mom, Feroz Dad, committee members cum Leela Fellow, Rupali Soni, principal of Belair College, and Kaudya Kausar Mulla, to please come forward to inaugurate today's award function in an eco-friendly way by watering of the potted plant.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Veda Thodai, LG 2012, and I am here to introduce to you the chief guest for today's function, Mr. Minocher Patel, renowned international corporate trainer and founder, director of the prestigious finishing school Ecole Solitaire. Words are too little to describe how elated I am at this opportunity of introducing such a magnanimous personality, but I will go ahead and give it a try. I sincerely hope that I am able to do justice to your body of work, sir. Silk and steel, a rare combination, can be a term used to best describe Mr. Patel, a man who dared to go down a path that is often unheard of, especially in India. A management graduate from the prestigious Symbiosis Institute of Business Management, Pune. He began his corporate career by working as a brand manager for the noted FMCG group, Wadilal. After stint with Wadilal, he moved on to seek greener pastures and joined Food Specialities Limited, Dubai, a successful assignment in the company as country manager led him to effectively take on three additional countries, namely Bahrain, Oman and Qatar, handling various international food brands. After this immensely successful assignment, there was no looking back for Mr. Patel, as he went on to handle the promotional activities for seven more countries within the Middle East. During his corporate days, Mr. Patel participated in the Train the Trainer program in West Germany and Finland. The year was 1988, when he first became involved in training, and then there was no looking back. Today, Mr. Patel has had an enviable record of conducting programs and corporate trainings, not just in India, but in UAE, Thailand, Sri Lanka, and Switzerland. A dear friend of mom and dad, Mr. and Mrs. Punavala, Mr. Minocher Patel has conducted many a training programs for the girls of LPF as well, thanks to his penchant for training the budding young minds. Mr. Patel has been a part of many top management institutes, both of national as well international repute. Not limiting his expertise to just training programs, the year is 1998 when Mr. Patel founded the premier Ecole Solitaire, mentioned in the Limca Book of Records, India's first residential finishing school and international corporate training consultancy, specializing in effective soft skills training on various topics like leadership skills, communication skills, business etiquette skills, customer service skills, time management skills, presentation skills, public speaking skills, selling skills, telephone etiquette skills, and specialized comprehensive personality development programs. A highly motivated speaker, he is known for his energizing demeanor. His unique way with words has also led him to author the motivational book, Ordinary to Extraordinary. After listening to the extraordinary story, This Ordinary Man wrote, I know all of you must be eager to hear him speak. So without further ado, I now invite Mr. Minocher Patel on stage to say a few words.
Good evening, everybody. First of all, let me thank Mrs. Leela Poonawala and Feroz Poonawala to invite me here. It's indeed an honor. I am a great supporter and a great admirer of the work the foundation does. You all are very blessed to be part of such a great foundation. I am blessed to be their friend for a long time. I have learned a lot of things just observing them. So when you're tired of learning from books, just come one day and see how Leela ma'am and Feroz sir operates. How they deal with people, how they treat people. I have learned a lot just seeing them. You know, they're walking, talking education institutes according to me. So the biggest blessings you have is just their presence in your life, apart from the money you get from the foundation, is apart from the training you'll get. I think the most precious thing is your access that you have to fantastic God-sent human beings like Mrs. Poonawala and Feroz Poonawala. So my request to you is in your 2-3 years, 4 years, in the interaction you'll have, try and spend maximum time with them. You'll learn a lot from them. It's just their presence will inspire you, as it has done for me. Anyways, now, a lot of people will tell you a lot of things, my friends, but what do you all want in life? Kya chahiye? Kya paaye? Me thoda thoda Marathi bolna. Kya paaye? Life mein tumhala kya paaye? Don't feel shy. Come on, all the young girls. College mein nahi bol bolta na? Aata kya hala? Please don't feel shy. What do you want in life? There is no negative marking. You're worried about giving the wrong answer? Who is that? Yeah. Yeah, please go ahead. What do you want in life? What's your name? Anuja. Anuja. Okay, sorry, Anuja. Yeah. So tell me, Anuja, what do you want? Success? How many of you want success out here? All of you want success? All of you want success. So one thing is good here, that you're already one step closer to success, being part of the foundation. So give yourself a big hand for that. Now, after being part of this foundation, your chances of achieving success are 100 times more than a normal human being. Let me tell you this. Because you're going to get exposed to some of the best training programs, so you're going to get exposed to Mrs. Poonawala, Mr. Feroz Poonawala, the best of other speakers. The whole interaction
the whole experience of being part of the foundation, and you've got dad and mom, the second dad and mom in your life, how many people in the world can claim that they have this privilege? So I hope you realize this privilege and don't take it for granted, because normally our human psyche is, once we get something, we take it for granted. Other bit luck, that time water. Right? But you are blessed and you are privileged. So remember that and make the most of the foundation. So like you said, you want success. But have you ever thought what will make you successful? How many of you are reading books on achieving success? How many of you are seeing videos on achieving success? Not many? Okay, I'll give you a tip. Go and read the book Ordinary to Extraordinary. It's a nice book. I've written that book with a lot of love and passion, and it's a national bestseller. It's also available in Marathi now. So maybe, you know, at some point, those who don't want to read it in English, you could pick up the book in Marathi. Not only my book, if you want to achieve success, read a lot of stuff on success and what makes you successful. But my first tip to you is to become successful. Remember, I'm going to give you a few tips quickly on how to achieve success. The first tip for you is to become successful, learn to be happy. A lot of people will say be successful. I'm saying first be happy. A lot of people say when you become successful, you'll be happy. That's the biggest lie. That's not true. When you are happy, the chances of becoming successful are higher. So when you go to college, go happily. When you go to the foundation, go happily. I see a lot of people moving around everywhere in serious faces. You see a lot of people everywhere around. Kai hala admi aise se. Ye bas zyada kare aise se nahi. Ye kaisa lag raha baap ko aisa. The whole bloody family is serious. We just don't know why. We are blessed. Why? When you have enough food to eat, you have enough clothes to wear, you have got good education, and now being part of the foundation, you should be such a happy human being. You should be walking with your chest out and proud of yourself and being happy. Unfortunately, our whole educational system is such that we are trained not to be happy. In fact, if a professor in a normal school or college sees a child smiling, why are you smiling? Nonsense, you come to college to smile? I am suffering, you also suffer. The whole education system is, so you will see schools and colleges like morgues, everybody walking seriously. If somebody is smiling, they say, oh, professor, don't smile now. If he catches you smiling, you're gone. Why? I see in offices, I ask people, I do a program for happy leadership for senior management and companies. I ask them, do you feel happy seeing your staff happy? They said, no, we get worried. Our whole Indian mentality is, if a staff is happy, that means they've got another job. Or they're not working. So most Indian employees are very smart. The moment the boss comes, yes sir. Very serious, and the boss feels very good. Ha, you're working. And somebody who's smiling and laughing a lot will say, ha, this person is not working, huh? Give him some work. He's always relaxed. It's amazing. And that's why they die early, most of serious people. You know, they die not of hard work, they die of living seriously. My request to you is, especially the women in this room, you're going to become mothers, you're going to play a very important role in other people's life. It's very important that a woman is happy. Because one happy woman can create a happy family. Don't be a serious woman. Especially if you're a little beautiful and intelligent, don't take yourself too seriously. You know? You have no credit for that. It's just that God gave you little more looks and little more brains than others. And the rest is makeup ka kamal. So we men have a disadvantage. Whatever, we can't do makeup. We are what we are. Anyways, my request to you is from today, learn to be happy. And I want to tell you something. Decide, ask yourself what makes me happy. Two things that make you happy. Do you know that? A lot of people don't know what makes them happy. It's amazing. It's a very simple question. Give it a deep thought when you go back home. What makes me happy? Because we are not conditioned to be happy. So from today, ask yourself what makes me happy and do at least one thing a day to make yourself happy. Because research is now showing if you are happy, you will work harder. Learn to party also, learn to celebrate. All the parents, tumcha mulanna maza karun dya. Is the right thing in Marathi? Yes. Lot of parents get worried. Tum maza karte? Nahi, 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 maza nahi karte, padhai karo constantly. That's some wrong thought. And you should learn from this age to learn to enjoy also. But remember, don't only enjoy. Enjoyment is a part of life. There's a very beautiful seasoning thing, a lot of shayari. So I'll give you a very good shayari, which I always tell my student. It says, Zindagi mein pehle kuch ban jao, phir thoda bigad jao, duniya maaf kar degi. Zindagi mein thoda kuch ban jao, phir thoda bigad jao, duniya maaf kar degi. कर देगी कुछ बनने के पहले बिगड़ मत जाना वो दुनिया कभी माफ नहीं करेगी सो व्हेन यू आर सक्सेसफुल एंड अ लिटिल नॉटी पीपल विल इग्नोर इट वेरी सक्सेसफुल है ना राइट सी इफ यू हैव अ वेरी पुअर अंकल एंड ही ड्रिंक्स एवरी डे सो बेवड़ा है नहीं बेटर ना करना रोज पीता बट इफ योर अंकल स्टेज इन करेगा पाव एंड ही हैज अ नाइस बंगलो Then you say, my uncle is so disciplined. Every day he has two pegs of scotch. And nothing wrong in it. It's just a mindset. We make look people look bad and good depending on how successful they are. So my request is focus on becoming successful and then life will be different for you. And work very hard and sincerely towards it. There is no shortcut to success. You've got to be crazily crazy. You have to be crazy about it. You have to do crazy things about it. Like I left my job and started the business from scratch. People thought I was crazy, including I'm sure once in a while my mom and dad too. But they were very supportive to me. But I'm sure that thought comes great. Beta, ita changa job sorun business karte. So people might think you're crazy, but you've got to be crazy to do crazy, extraordinary things in life. You've got to be crazy. And a lot of you will have that, you'll have to make a decision, should I do this crazy thing? Should I start this new business? All entrepreneurs are a little crazy. They're ready to do something out of the ordinary. They don't want ordinary life. And they have vision. Even if they don't get business for a few months, they in their mind are very calm. They know business will come. When they start from scratch, they're ready to see the vision which others can't see. So all of you remember, the first thing you need to do is set a clear goal. What do I want to achieve? And Leela ma'am is a classic example. She came from a very poor family and today she's all a role model for all of us. So for all of you, she's a living legend, living role model. If she can become the managing director of Alpha Lavan and run such a successful foundation, I think, I'm sure she'll agree, all of you girls can work as hard and do that, right? So you should keep Leela ma'am's photograph on your laptop, on your phones. Really, I'm serious about that. I'm not joking about it. Because visually you should say, I want to become like this woman. You need somebody, a role model in your life, normally, that will help you. Keep a photograph. Don't keep Salman Khan, Shah Rukh Khan. They can't do it. Lot of girls, Salman Khan's a photograph. I can't do it. Shah Rukh Khan's a photograph. That is also important, that little glamour in life, that must be important. But have a role model in your life, and I think Leela ma'am can be your best role model, you know. And one day I think my request to her is, listen to her whole story, how she reached where she reached. And it inspired you. When I heard the story first time, it inspired me. So I think, if you want to be successful, set a clear goal and go after it like crazy and believe that dreams come true. Right? Do not ever think. Lot of people will say, "Asa hota ka?" And aisa hoga to sabhi successful ban jayenge. Lot of people will discourage you. Dhirubhai Ambani, the first time he found his friend, he was a clerk in a small company. So he told somebody, "One day I will." He was working for Shell. So when he was living Shell Corporation, he told his friends, "Ki one day I will make a company as big as Shell, if not bigger, the same size." So they all said, Dhirubhai to gayo ho. That means he lost it. They thought he's mad. His friend said, we thought he lost it. But later on, Dhirubhai Ambani proved himself right. So all successful people, they have crazy dreams. I want you to dream big. Unfortunately, our education system makes us dream small. We are not taught to dream big. And when will you dream big? You know what is the secret? You need to have crazy confidence. You got to feel good about yourself. Can you just see it? Sangye. Every day stand in front of the mirror and say, Sangye. I mean, believe in that and say it. You know? Means you should say, I'm something. You need to have confidence, all of you. Remember that. So first is confidence. Of course, it's a long story how to build your confidence. Maybe when we do a training program, I'll talk more about it. But remember, confidence is absolutely crucial. Your emotional quotient is very, very important. How you build yourself emotionally. Most youngsters nowadays waste a lot of time in useless relationships. Hey, Ramu says, I am in love with Ramu, Pandu, whatever. No harm in being in love. But right now, at this age, my research is showing, when I wrote my book, I did research. In the age group of 16 to 21 is the most crucial age for any student. In that age, if you study hard, of course, even till 25, 16 to 25, if you focus on your goals, if you really work hard and go after it without losing any emotional energy here and there, your chances of success are 100 times more. So remember this, if you want to succeed, be emotionally solid and don't waste your emotional energies here and there. Focus on your career. Because if you want to win a prize, for every prize, PRI is ready. There is a price, PRIC. Be ready to pay that price. You got to be disciplined. You got to know what you want in life and sacrifice the other things. And once you get that, then you can go back to your normal routine, whatever you want to do. So the most important thing is, if you want to achieve success, be motivated, be confident, and third, very important thing, what is that? Any guesses? Anybody? So happy we already spoke. How many times have we spoken? Anybody else? What do you need? First is, you have to be happy to achieve success. Second is, you have to have a clear goal. You have to be motivated towards that goal. And what's the next one? Very, very important. A clear career plan. You should know where you're going. Plan out a career very well and go after it like crazy. Have a clear career plan. Most people get confused. They don't know what they keep changing. You must know what, the earlier in life you know what you want to become, the better for you. Research is showing people have a clear career graph, career path in front of them, their graph is better. So always focus on this. And the next, there is one more important thing. What is that? If you want to be successful. Anybody? Hard work that hides. Hard work that is taken for granted here. That is very old-fashioned now. Character. Remember, be a good human being. If you want to be successful, be a good human being. If you're a good human being, you help others, you're kind to others, you're good to people around you, you love others, your intent is nice towards everybody, God will help you. God will send angels in your life to help you. Somebody out of the blue will come and say, come, I'll help you. But for that, you have to be a very good human being. Don't harm anybody. Don't wish bad for anybody. Very, very crucial. And there's one more very important thing is, you have to be spiritually strong in today's crazy world. What do I mean by spiritual strength? You got to believe in God, not necessarily praying. A lot of people mistake. They can pray 10 times a day and keep hurting people 10 times a day. No use. Prayers is overrated. According to me, prayers are important, but more than prayers is good living. What are you doing with your life? Leela is praying every day in her work. Are you getting my point? Through your work, prayers are most important. Make your work your prayers. And the best form of spirituality is, you know what? Anybody? The best form of spirituality is giving others. And that's what this foundation does. And today all of you are going to benefit from it because two people in their lives thought that we should give. If they would have thought like typical industrialists around there, let us keep it with ourselves. The country will have, there are too many people to help. A lot of people tell me, how can we make a difference? There's so many people to help. But that's not how they thought. They thought that we can give and make a difference, right? So the best spirituality is about being a good human being, kind human being, and a giving human being. And I want you to take an oath today that when I become somebody, I will give back. In fact, you must make sure then when you become rich enough, you must pay back the money to the foundation. That's my personal view. So that one more girl or two more girls can benefit. Don't take it and keep quiet. When you must promise yourself that when I get this much money, I'm going to give back 10 times more to the foundation. So 10 more girls can get educated and their lives can change. Anyway, I have a lot to say. I'm a motivational speaker. I can keep talking, so I won't take much of your time. I wish you guys, and you know, less guys, more girls. So I wish you all you girls all the best. I wish you all the success. I wish you all an extraordinary life. God bless you all. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.
Thank you very much, sir, for your kind and inspirational words. We are indeed grateful to you for advising and encouraging our eager Leela girls to achieve their dreams and fulfill their aspirations. I'm sure they will inculcate and imbibe your message of going from ordinary to extraordinary. I now request Leela Mom to felicitate our chief guest, Mr. Minocher Patel, with a token of our appreciation.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Dad. Thank you, Mom.